Hello guys, let's make a simple health bar in Unreal 5, and we will do it in a first person template from the scratch. So I will try to make it simple as possible and fast. Once you will run the project, let me delete this stuff. So let's start from the beginning. We have this project from this template, first person template, and we can shoot objects. First, let me fix the gun. It's too loud. Yeah, now I can hear you. Tak, couple things. Okay, now we're talking. I wanna add simple health bar to HP bar to any object. Let's try like this. I will create new actor, I'll call it BP unit, and I will also create a widget. Like this. Our widget will be very simple. It will be customs, custom size. And inside it will be a progress bar. And it will be on the left, it will be like this. Let's set it half filled, so we will see how it go. Tak, in Unreal 5, it's already animation on, so let's turn it off. Okay, and then let's go back to our unit, and we will add widget as a widget. But first let's add some kind of mesh, so we will see how it looks like, how it will be looking on the level. Yeah, and in the widget we will, in widget class field, we will pick our widget. Here we are, it's somewhere here. Let's see how it will look like in world, like this, and compare it to the other. Actually, we wouldn't see anything because it's on other side. So let's rotate the actor to us. Now we can see it. By default, it's not there where we need it. We should change the anchor for our progress bar. Let's set it to the center. Along with the anchor, we need to fix alignment. So let's pick it pivot point inside the bar. Now it is inside. Let's make it a little bit more higher. Let's make it higher. Let's do like this. We will change it here for one reason. Okay, but it's not good. It doesn't follow us around. So there's two possible ways to fix it. First of all, we can just send its space to the screen instead of the world. So we will see it always on our screen. But there's a problem. It will be always on our screen, and if the object behind us, behind anything else, and we should not see it, we will see it. It's not good. So let's fix it. Let's keep it to the world. But now we have the other problem, that if we will go around it, we will not see it. So we need a simple way to look at this widget so it will follow us. For a moment, we will use, we'll always try to look at the player. So we'll take the widget, we will get player, character. So now we have two objects, and one should be rotated towards the other. There's a location, get location, and Unreal have already this option, look at function. Okay, and now all we need to do is just change the rotation for our widget. But our widget, yeah, here we go. We will change relative to world rotation. Now we can set rotation. Let's hook it up. Here we go. And let's see the result. Now it follows me. Even if I jump, if I will jump, it will do the same. Like this is good. So the other problem, now let's see if it's working. So in first person template, as we can see, these blocks are already affected by the bullets and our block is not. The reason is because they have turned on physics. Let's do the same for our group. Checkbox simulate physics. Okay. Yeah, and I can now hit it. But our bar will stay flying in the world. So it's very easy fix. Let's just with the mouse move it here and make a child of the coop. Let's see. Yeah, it works. Nice. But how to make it so the bar will see how much hit points this coop have. So let's go to the unit and let's define what is it health for it mean. So let's create two variables, HP, and another one is HP max. By default, let's give our unit 100 hit points. I usually do like this. I declare HP max and then I will just set HP based on how much we set it. So I will not write the same number twice. Yeah, like this. It's not enough. It's just variables inside the unit. Now we need to showcase it somehow on our bar. And it's quite easy to do. All we need to do is create binding. So we click on the progress bar, there's a percent property, and we click bind. But we cannot do much right now, so we will go to the graph and we will create variable unit, and it will be our unit like this. So now if you will switch to designer, click on the bar, click on the binding for the percent, we can see the unit, and actually we can like pick here, but it will not serve the purpose because we don't need to see on the bar how much hit points we have, but we would like to see how much HP compared to HP max. So we will create the binding. Let's call it bind HP. Okay. And here is a simple way to do it. Get HP. Get HP max. And we need one divide on the other. There you go. If you will try now, we will see the arrow. There's a reason for that. Because we did not define what this unit is. So first of all, let's fix this problem for future. I don't like to see errors in my log. Yeah. But it will not fix our bar because this HP bar doesn't know which unit he is tracking. So let's help with that. And in viewport, we can see that we have coop and we have HP bar. So we will go to the begin play. Let's get the widget. Widget, it's a widget component. So we will get widget from there. Just to understand why there's two widgets. This one is just component, and inside he have a widget class which we are using. And this get widget, we will get this. We will get a widget class from here. So we need to cast it. And like this. We have our HP bar, and now we can use this set unit. And we will set it to self. Here we are. Let's make it fancy. Why not? Compile, check. Here we go. And as you can see, this bar is full. which makes sense. From the beginning they have full health. Yeah, let's now make simple. let's apply damage to our object. So I will go to the projectile, which is already in the system plate, this yellow button, yellow bullet. And before destroying bullet, when it will reach any kind of physical component, what I will do, I will cast to unit, meaning that if our bullet will hit something which is simulating physics, and this component is a component of actor who may be BP unit, then we will apply damage. Yeah, that's just subtract 10 points. Okay, then let's go to the unit. Now let's add a callback for this we need event. Yeah, and we have HP which we wanna change. Get HP minus subtract damage, and it will be our new HP. Let's connect and see and check if it's working. Oh yeah, it does work. Here we go, it's very simple. HP bar, and let's keep this one short, and I will make another one where we can create component which we can add to any object, and it will to any actor, and it will work from the get-go. Okay, thanks guys.